Hey, Tara Cherie here with you. I don't have a whole lot of time today, so I wanted to keep the message really short, and I'm just gonna jump into it. I was in prayer yesterday and this morning, and I received a word that I wanted to share with you. And I just wanted to encourage or remind those of you that are going through a battle or a struggle of some sort, that you are going to make it through and you are going to overcome whatever that battle is, whatever that looks like. And the thing is that you have to remember in times of warfare or struggle, just know that it's an endless opportunity for you, that the possibilities are endless, because the thing is you're not fighting against physical realm. So don't even try to think about reinventing the wheel here. Instead, you're supposed to just rest and trust in the Lord and trust that He's bringing you out of whatever the situation is, because it's not our job always to fix every situation. On the other hand, we shouldn't just wait on the Lord to prevail on things. Sometimes there are action steps and things that must be taken in order for us to accomplish something or in order for us to be able to move forward. The difference is that it's not in our own strength. So we're not meant to fix things in our own strength. And some of us just need that reminder. I believe somebody that's going to be watching this needs that reminder. It's not up to us to physically fix things ourselves, but the Lord will come along and fix whatever it is that we need from Him, or if we need some sort of breakthrough, He will come along and take care of that and handle whatever it is that we're going through. But at the same time, it may require some action in Him. And it's not our job to question, but just our job to obey what it is that He's asking us to do. Because I really believe that the Lord, especially in this spiritual season, He wants to release people. He wants to do away with what needs relinquished. I mean, He's the opposite of that, right? Like, He wants to give us every good and perfect thing that's a gift from Him. And in order to do that, we have to let go of our own logic of the things that we think need solutions or need fixed. And we see the needs, but sometimes we need to let go and we need to trust. And that is still an action step. Did you know that rest is being obedient, but rest is also an action step that needs to be taken in order for the Lord to prevail on our behalf, because He wants to say that He did it. Okay, so the battle sometimes is completely spiritual, and we have to stand up and take that territory and reclaim what He has promised for our lives, the good work that He's promised that He's going to do through us and with us. And it goes along with the message that I did Tuesday on the Refiner's Fire with the Diamonds, right? It's the same concept that we need to continue to let go. And he reaffirms that in messages of two or three. So I really believe that this is a word that's meant for more than just a couple people. This is a message that we really need to take to heart in this season, that even though not every battle is meant for ours to be fixed, it's not good enough to sometimes just stand around and wait for God. Sometimes we need to take that next action step. But if we're not resting, we cannot hear what that action step is. We cannot fulfill that role of obedience. So we cannot forget in this season to rest and allow God to purpose his time and his strategies, and to give us wisdom and knowledge. If you really want to see God show up and move on your behalf, knowledge and wisdom and guidance are key. So make sure that in your rest time that you're asking for that revelation, so that way when that comes, you're not doing it any longer in your own strength and you're doing it in Him. And when you obey, blessing follows. It's endless opportunity. No matter what giant you're facing, what you're battling, it's endless opportunity. When you're going through warfare, Just know, here's a different perspective. Just know that you've intimidated the enemy because he knows that the Lord is working things out. He's strategizing even back behind the scenes and working everything out for your good. So you can take rest assurance that when you're in seasons of warfare, it's because you're doing something really right. And the Lord is testing you for that next level of promotion. So don't just disregard that or focus on the warfare. Instead, focus on the Lord and the plan and the strategy that He has. And the best way to overcome a season of warfare is through rest. So you have those strategies. I really believe this is for someone. And if this is you, I hope that this message has totally blessed you. I think the point is made. I really don't need to go on about it. It's pretty clear what needs to be done. But I encourage you, if you're feeling this tug, just to pray about it a little bit more and just to trust, let go of some things and rest. And I know sometimes it's really hard for us to do because it doesn't always logically make sense. And sometimes we don't understand. And we're begging to understand why that is. But rest assured, if God is laying a message on your heart or word, just take it to rest and rest in Him and let Him do the healing. Let Him do the work. Let Him bring you out of the situation because He doesn't want you to say that you did it. He wants to say that He did it. He wants to show up on His behalf. He loves you and He wants to give you the very best. He wants to give you His best so that way you're a testimony for Him of His great love as you shine and help others exhibit His love. So it is a blessing to be a blessing. Amen. Anyway, I will leave my contact details here in the comments if you want to stay in touch. If you haven't already, definitely join our VIP list so you can stay tuned and be the first to know about updates that we have. And as well, I am still taking some one-on-one clients for coaching. So if something is moving you, even in the spiritual realm, or you want some spiritual clarity on some things, I would love to help you through that. I'm going to leave my link so that you can click on it and fill out your information. And that way we can have a free 30-minute consult and talk about that a little bit more. I hope that you have a great rest of your week. If you haven't already, definitely go back and watch the replay. It was a powerful word. So I encourage you to go back and listen to that. And, next Tuesday is, for some, is Christmas. And so I'm going to be spending some time with my family. So we won't be having a Facebook Live on Tuesday. However, I will plan to pick up things on Thursday at between 12:50 and 1, I would say, Eastern Standard Time. So be looking for updates on that so you can stay tuned. Anyway, it's been a real pleasure. Definitely go back and watch the replay because it was a powerful word. And I will look forward to seeing you next Thursday. If I don't get to talk with you before then, or we don't get a chance to connect, I wish you a happy holiday season. And I hope that you can get some good quality time with your family. And I will be thinking of each of you. Talk to you on Thursday. Bye for now.